reaction of zinc with dilute sulfuric acid. Everything that has mass and volume is called matter. All matter, regardless of state, undergoes physical and chemical changes. A physical change occurs when a substance changes its state but does not change its chemical composition. For example, tearing a paper, melting of cheese, and cutting a piece of wood into smaller pieces are physical changes. A chemical change occurs when a substance changes into something new. For example, formation of a precipitate, evolution of a gas, and corrosion are chemical changes. In this experiment, our aim is to carry out the reaction of zinc with dilute sulfuric acid and classify it as a physical or a chemical change. Materials required: boiling tube, dilute sulfuric acid, NaOH, zinc dust, spatula, and a dropper. Procedure: take a boiling tube and add a few drops of dilute sulfuric acid using a dropper and place it in a test tube rack. Then add some zinc dust into the boiling tube using a spatula. In this reaction, zinc reacts with dilute sulfuric acid to form an aqueous solution of zinc sulfate, and hydrogen gas evolves. That is, Zn plus H2SO4 gives you ZnSO4 plus H2. Now, take a red litmus paper and hold it over the mouth of the boiling tube. There is no change in the color of the red litmus paper. Repeat the same step with blue litmus paper. In this case as well, no change is observed. From this, we can infer that hydrogen gas evolved is neither acidic nor basic in nature. We can do two tests to confirm the presence of zinc sulfate solution in this reaction. In the first test, add a few drops of NaOH solution into the boiling tube containing zinc sulfate using a dropper. On adding the NaOH, a white gelatinous precipitate of zinc hydroxide is formed. ZnSO4 plus 2NaOH gives you ZnOH2 plus Na2SO4. Again, add excess of NaOH into this white precipitate and shake the boiling tube well. We can see that the precipitate dissolves on adding excess NaOH. In the second test, take a clean boiling tube and clamp it in a stand and add a small amount of ferrous sulfide into this boiling tube using a spatula. Close the mouth of the boiling tube with a double bored cork and insert a thistle funnel and a bent tube into the two different holes in the rubber cork. Then take a boiling tube containing zinc sulfate solution and clamp it in another stand. Now, add a few drops of dilute HCl to the boiling tube containing ferrous sulfide using the thistle funnel. We can see that hydrogen sulfide gas evolves in the boiling tube containing ferrous sulfide. That is, FeS plus 2HCl gives you FeCl2 plus H2S. This hydrogen sulfide gas passes through the bent tube and reacts with zinc sulfate solution to form a white precipitate of zinc sulfide. That is, ZnSO4 plus H2S gives you ZnS plus H2SO4. Precautions: use the chemicals judiciously. Keep the mouth of the boiling tube away from your face and also from other classmates.